Hello, I'm Dr. Tahir Yaqub, and if you are looking for a free alternative to MATLAB, you are at the right place. In this short video, I will introduce to you a software called Scilab. Scilab is a scientific computation software which is an alternative to MATLAB. This software was created in 1990, and now it has been serving the scientific and research community for the last 28 years. I started using Scilab in 2008 when I was doing my postdoctorate at the University of Ulster, Northern Ireland, UK. And since then, for my control system or for my numerical computation problems, I use Scilab. And I encourage my students to use Scilab. This type of open source software, they offer some of the advantages which their proprietary counterpart don't have. For example, transparency. The source code is visible to the community. Any developer, any programmer can look into the source code. So it means that they can find the limitations of the software or if there are any bugs, and they can fix them. And the community is supportive. Community is very supportive to other users, and you will find a lot of forums where you can get the answers to your problems. So similarly, for the same reason of transparency, these software are also very reliable. And because more eyes means that more probability that the bugs and limitations will be fixed. And these software are considered more secure. So for the last 10 years, the popularity of open source software is growing. And above all, you don't have to pay anything. As you know that MATLAB is a very expensive software. On the other hand, Scilab, you don't have to pay anything. So let me show you some of the features of the software. So let us first see where does Scilab stands in computational software. So there are two types of computational software, symbolic computation software and numerical computation software. So in symbolic computation, variables are treated as symbols. We manipulate variables with symbols, and we do not give any value to these variables. We can find the values of x, y, a, b just like in algebra. So therefore, these type of systems are sometimes also called computer algebra system, because it's just as same as you are doing algebra with computers. For scientific and engineering works, you need numerical computation where you can actually get decimal values for your variables. We have to use numerical computation if we are doing a scientific or engineering work. And if you look at the software in symbolic computation, there are many software available. Two are very famous. One is Mathematica and the other is Maple. In numerical computation, MATLAB is the market leader. MATLAB has millions of users. In many universities and colleges, they have MATLAB and a lot of community. But MATLAB is a proprietary software. It's a commercial software which is very expensive. And the second problem is that you cannot modify the code because you cannot see the source code of MATLAB. While in Scilab, Scilab is an open source software. So the biggest advantage is that you don't have to pay anything for this. And the second important thing is that you can modify the code however you like. Both of these software can handle other programming languages, but in Scilab, you can, if you have some old programs written in Fortran or C, Fortran is an old language, so you can put those codes into Scilab. You can integrate because you have the access to the Scilab source code. So this is a little comparison of the software. Now let us see how it looks. It has a beautiful integrated development environment. You have a command prompt, you have a command history window and other windows just like MATLAB. You can either run the internal function using the command prompt as you do in MATLAB, or you can write your own program. And in order to write a program, you can use the internal editor called Scinodes, which can be accessed from the left top corner. And you can, if you have programs written somewhere else, you can copy paste, then you can save and run the program, and it will show you the graphs. And if you want to use, you can also use the notepad where you write and save a program and then execute it from the command prompt. Now we look at some of the computations which can be performed in Scilab. It is impossible to mention everything here, but I have highlighted some of them. You can perform all types of arithmetic operations,
algebraic and matrices operations. In Scilab, you can handle various types of matrices, matrices of real and complex numbers, matrices of rational numbers, matrices of strings, just like sentences, and also the matrices of polynomials. So these are all the types of matrices which you can use here. Then you can generate different types of 2D and 3D graphs in Scilab. You can also solve linear algebraic problems, numerous type of problems. Then you can also solve differential equations in Scilab if you have the initial conditions available to you. As far as control is concerned, you can get the time and frequency response of control system. You can plot root locus diagrams, Bode plot, and Nyquist diagrams. Then you can also perform numerical integration, and you can also have a lot of variety of block diagrams. Now we talk about the last two points, the block diagrams and the simulation. So you might be wondering that whether Scilab has something similar to Simulink of the MATLAB, and the answer is yes, we have, which is called Xcos. Xcos is similar to Simulink. It has a large library of block diagrams. And it is very important for any numerical software to be able to simulate and model the hybrid type of dynamic systems. And Xcos can do this with the help of the block diagrams. So now I will show you the palettes which we have. So these are the palettes which we have in Xcos. So it has a large library of palettes, and it covers all the signal processing, control systems, electrical systems, and mathematical computations. So all these type of computations can be performed using these block diagrams. You can model the system and then you can simulate it. And these palettes are very good documented. You have a help file available which gives you the detail of the palettes. And if you click on any of the individual palettes, you can get the further details, what parameters you have to put in this palette. So this is a huge library. So you are able to model and simulate any type of dynamic system.
So after this brief introduction, if you are in a research career, if you are in an academic or scientific career and you do numerical computation, I invite you to join me inside the course. There is a 30-day 100% money-back guarantee, so there is no reason to hesitate. So there are free preview videos are available. You can have a look at some of the videos and you can see whether this course is for you. And just learn some new things and try making your own numerical functions and your numerical algorithms. So I hope that this short video will help you and encourage you to join the course, and I will see you inside the course.